I, for today's teardown, something in a wooden box, new old stock from the Ministry of Defense surplus stores. I got this for 15 British pounds, so you can consider it was funded by the British taxpayers. One more time. What do we have in here? VS, VHSC, VCR side from Thales Optronics Limited. Do we have a date code somewhere? Two thousand three here maybe? .2203, so probably with 22,000 free, yes. So it is a VCR side of onboard video data recorder for HUD, probably from fighter aircraft, most probably the famous or infamous Tornado. So the box is a new old stock. Almost, so we can expect to have something in a nice condition in here. Let me undo the screws. Six of them. It is not every day you get something in a crate. And the feeling of uncrating is really, really nice. Last here we are. So are you ready? Ta-da! First the cover, silica gel manufactured in 2002, some unused clips here, so not sure if they are for the silica gel or something else. Big foam blocks, apparently they are not decayed, which is good. And here is what we have inside. Let me put this here. Little bit of wood dust on it. Big red strap and control tag. The crate is covered here inside with a cloth to protect the device. Nice. So I try to pull it out of the box, but it is actually quite heavy. Okay, bottom, more foam blocks and more silica gel. As expected. So what do we have in here? This module. Vinten Limited. Serviceable. Yes, it was serviceable in 2003. And according to the here, the label, it was made in December of 1998, so it was controlled 5 years later and since never installed apparently, and I am just checking here, look at this. It is not because it is supposedly new old stock, in fact I did already open it one time, but you can see rusty screws all around, so it was probably stored in most conditions and the silica gel was not enough for a long enough period at least. So we just have a box with these fasteners and one door. If I open the door, power must be applied to allow cassette ejection. remove tab slack. This door must remain closed between tab changes. OK. And what do we have? It looks like we have a regular video cassette tape drive with those two big screws, which I believe might be storage screws actually, to undo, to uninstall before use, because I see big shock absorbers here at the back, but they are not going to work with these big screws in the way. We have here, all at the rear, apparently two switches, one plug and one light. Okay, pretty serious aluminium door here, made of milled aluminium block. And it is all for the outside, just two connectors, one of them is covered. Okay, actually I have the connector cap for here, but it is not the, it was provided with this one, but it is not the correct size. Okay, and the sticker here is a little bit ungluing. Interesting. So I guess it is time to get the screwdriver and try to open it. Well, as I said, actually I already opened it one time because the screws here were completely stuck and it did require quite a lot of work to unlock them. So I know there is a little retainer here to unlock also. And it's just a matter of undoing four big screws. Now they are unlocked and much easier to deal with, but you can believe me, when I received the item, almost I was afraid not to be able to open it, because really, they were hard. Now I applied some oil on the thread, and you can see it is all dried again. So I will probably do it another time before reassembling the item. So what I am very curious with this, do we have just a regular Japan made VCR tape drive in a fancy box? Or is it a regular drive with special electronics? Or is it completely aircraft specific? We will find out. So it will just pull out like so. Okay. The case has nothing else except this retainer piece at the back here. You need to unscrew a little bit in order to be able to pull the contents. Okay, so what do we have? Pretty serious metal construction. You can see here this box for the tape drive itself. So far I am not really able to I am able to tell if it is a Japanese. At least look, the head drum is GVC branded. So we have a weird contraption here with electronics on the front, with big aircraft specific connector, and apparently a big circuit board at the bottom. And I believe probably more electronics in here. So what to do first? Obviously I need to unscrew those retainers. Yes, look at this. They are made to be removed easily on these things here will not come off. Okay, and now the tape drive is mounted onto shock absorbers and can work easily. Okay, and I can eventually try to remove it. So apparently we have just one connector here to undo that will allow complete removal of the tape unit for field maintenance probably. So it should replace just this unit. Okay, quite easy. So whenever you have a connector like this with a screw each hand, always undo evenly the screws. We have here a very nice golden switch, probably for the exact instruction. And it looks like we are now secured by these four parts here, which are quite easy to unscrew. Okay, do not go in a hardware store and ask for these parts. Imperial Fred, flat head with two holes like this, you will never get it. So whenever you take apart all the avionics, it is typically the kind of hardware you want to keep. But this one will go in my collection, obviously. So yes, as I said, here we have V and SV video and super video, maybe. R for rewind, I guess. Speed selector and some kind of a LEMO plug. ET, extraterrestrial, no. External something. So I guess we will first have a look at this tape unit and then I will proceed further on the teardown. Okay, it should come off without other problems. Okay, very nice board with what seems to be a mix of regular consumer video parts and military grade parts. And it is flat flex rigid construction, so it will be very nice to look at later. First we check this thing. So as you can see, we have this aluminium frame with on the back power resistors, probably for temperature control of the thing. Here a module with well, it is really interesting. A potted module, it is called IC1, but I need to undo the mechanism here, by the way. How do you undo this? There is a little connector here. I guess it will need to go sooner or later, so let's undo it. There is this front piece here that I probably need to screw. It will be a number of screws, by the way, this teardown. The weird part here, apparently they were missing some space to fit a circuit board. And they did. So I wonder, did they purchase these drives OEM from GVC, or did they retrieve them in videotape recorders, for example, or in camcorders. probably broadcast grade, but really, really weird. This seems to be an added plate, not original. Probably, yes, to allow easy manipulation of tape unit. Okay. So we have this with four wires, maybe for the eject button. As you can see, this is totally GVC bonded, so part of a tape drive unit, and it looks like, I am not really sure, but it looks like some parts here were unsoldered. Look at here and here. These wires here are bulged. It is probably the control for the eject button, I guess. And there is a board-to-board connector here. Okay, so the tape drive itself, you can see it was never used because look at this. You still have some dots of grease applied on the wheel here at regular spots, but it was not sprayed all around by moving the part, so it is really new old stock. So the tape drive itself has nothing very interesting apparently, except, look at this, we have a problem here. This capstan wheel is rubber wheel is covered with white gunk at a regular spacing. Quite weird. We will maybe be able to see it better if I am able to remove the tape drive from the unit here, just to check a little bit more what we have. Apparently there is an unpopulated connector here. Probably for test purpose or something like this. Do I have the correct screwdriver to do this? Okay, could be worse. So really, really unusual part. I was wanting some of those onboard tape recorders for a long time. So you find them for use on airliners for reading the video entertainment, and you find them for military aircraft. So what do we have, and will it come off or not? It may, it should, it could come off if I undo some more screws. You always need to undo more screws. And of course, the screws you need to undo will not collaborate. I need to protect the table first. So here it seems I have an issue with these two. And it is not because they are small screws that they are not stuck. Sometimes, wow, small screws are harder to undo. Wow, really? Are you kidding me? It is the only thing preventing me to... Well, interesting. Can I proceed without unscrewing this? More or less. We will go like this. As you can see, first here, probably the temperature control unit for the thing. I do not see temperature probe. But you can see there is some kind of a potted module here by Oxley ET2010/78. Ok. The power resistors are all connected in parallel and connected to this. So yes, it is just a temperature control. You have your L-section button here, wired also. We have this board apparently is the board that goes together with this step drive provided at the same time. Is it GVC? Not sure. So it seems to be very well, maybe broadcast grade board with bodges here apparently. You can see this is definitely a modification from the Vinten company because the wires here are the military grade. They did add this little board here. Adjustment PCB, it is written. So enough spots for six potentiometers. Only three of them connected. You can see here we have a capacitor which must be original here because the wires are not the Teflon wires. Then very regular stuff actually for camcorder circuit board. AT&T IC here, it is not every day you see an AT&T IC. And yes, so they did bulge all their wires over this board. You can see here also some more rust or oxidation here on the aluminum. Interesting. But this is also, of course, on the other side we have more integrated circuits and more parts. But this is all a part of original tape drive. So you already find a number of video cassette recorder tape drives teardowns on YouTube. Very common part. Here you can see a little bit better maybe the problem with this capstan wheel covered with gunk. Not sure exactly what did happen here because it is obviously new out of stock. So yes, how many video heads do we have? Seems it is five, maybe six. Interesting. Regular little motors and everything. Okay, so this is all for this part, obviously. So nothing very special here, just camcorder tape drive with wires and some modifications bulge on it. So I will put back this unit together and we will continue. So we continue with this unit. Obviously, if I want to look inside here, I first need to undo this board. Anyways, if we want to look at it better, I need to undo it. So here around the connectors, the screws are not original. I had to replace them because actually, when I received the item, the screws around the connectors were even more rusty than the other ones, and they were slotted screws. Those quite typical British slotted screws with a recess in the middle. And it means it was almost impossible to unscrew them. I believe I did not need to drill anyone, but still, it has been quite a fight to undo them. And they were not possible to retrieve after this. So, luckily enough, I have a big stock of screws and I found the matching ones, well, almost. So here we have all because here is a screw that is all at the bottom here. This one. And of course, you will need an extra long screwdriver of some kind to be able to access it. Do I have one? extra long screwdriver of some description. No, it's extra too short. And here, do I have? I will try this, but maybe it will be too large for the screw. Maybe, maybe not. I can try. If okay. Thank you very much. I am not missing a lot actually. Just 1 centimeter. Really? Very, very nice when it happens in the middle of putting the video. What else do I have? Let me figure it out. This will be too big. This will not go in here. This over. I have a huge stock of screwdriver, guys, but sometimes it is not good enough. If I do this, no, it will not work also. What else? I must find something. I am sure I can find something. Look at this. I am missing what? One centimeter. Can I undo here the shock absorber maybe? I will try this. And again, no, because again the annoying British screws that will strip very easily. So let me figure it out and I will be right back. So I found a screwdriver long enough, but at some point I modified it for some reason. Slight modification as you can see. But it did allow me to at least unlock the screw. And then I can use the old broken screwdriver to continue undoing the screw. Like so. It is really a pain. You never have enough screwdrivers for special situations, really. Hopefully the other screws will not be such a problem. Well, not even sure, because they are all almost out of reach. And again, annoying slotted screws. And for some reason, they did. Maybe the screws were on sale that day and they use a number of screws on that bar. And really? Wow. Insane. So even here, when I have reached on the screw, yes, you really need to have a straight access, because if not, because of a recess in the middle. Look at this. Can you see this? There is a little recess in the middle of the screw. And I do not know why, if it is a manufacturing thing, or if it is on purpose, but really they are annoying. And typical of British hardware. Military hardware, even. Okay. I believe they are all gone. Now, I hope this is a connector. I guess it will be. And it will come off. Maybe. Yes. Okay. So So I should be able to lift and pull everything out of the way, maybe like such. Okay, so the frame now. Yes, obviously we have more electronics in here. We can see the wires behind here, just wires going to the two buttons, one LED and one connector, and the same little bridge retaining part here. Probably also very impossible to unscrew, but first let's have a look to this. So very fancy flex rigid assembly with a nice silk screen on both sides. You can see why. So maybe one side will be more for manufacturing purpose to put the correct part in the correct holes, and the other side will be more for maintenance purpose to be able to probe the part you want. Little bulge here, so super big flat flex assembly here with, you can see this special connector. And this one also for the tape drive. So what do we have in here? So these parts are little coils. They are typical from video equipment. It is called the Vinton Analog Control PCB. Okay. So apparently some yes, video processing parts. Soon maybe also. And some IC to control the tape drive. So sadly there is a sticker on over this IC, so it is not possible to tell what it is. I am checking if it is not easy to tell if it is soldered directly or if it is socketed. It looks like it is a socket. And not really sure, just a little bit of probing around. Well, I will not attempt any further. It seems to be sockets. Here I can see at one angle, you can see this one, this pin here. Seems to be a socket, but it will not move. So you can see the test points on this PCB. Super nice and golden test points. Really, with a little sphere at the end. Very beautiful parts. All the ICs are military grade ceramic. Maxim, National Semiconductor maybe. So LM13A, MAX454. You can search them out. And seems to be a programmable part here. And look at this. Is it Swiss made? It is written Swiss, Swiss everywhere. But no, it is British made. So in fact, it is not written Swiss. It is written software issue. So we have software in here and in here. 5 megahertz quartz oscillator here from Euroquartz. Thank you very much. Some kind of, yes, white tantalum capacitors here. Regular metal foil resistors here. Precision ones here. Okay. Ah, two plastic ICs here. Two more. Op amps probably. So an interesting mix of parts here. Okay, now time to undo this panel and check what we have behind. So again, small slotted screws to undo. Seems we have here just one aluminium plate fielding. Whatever is inside. So probably, I guess we will have power supply, but maybe more electronics for control and signal conversion. For some reason, they did not use a screw here in the corner. Quite weird. But also, okay, very, very tight fit. Okay, we have circuit board with, I need to undo this connector first. Okay, try to figure out how to undo this thing. It looks like first I will need to undo the screws around the connector. It is not even maybe, it is sure. So let's undo them. Then we have maybe this, I am not sure, it is a grounding point. So for this, I will use some modern tool from 1938. It is written here. Okay. It looks like it is collaborating with me, more or less. Good. Then I have four screws. And maybe all the guts will come out, I hope. So these screws also were super tight and I had to help them a little bit with WD-40. Okay, so in theory everything is loose, but I know this thing is stuck in fact in the box. So it is a good thing I have this bent screwdriver. Ah, okay. It looks like this time it is coming off almost. It is actually very annoying because I am not sure why it will not come out so far. They love making super tight fits, really. Try to not damage the flat flex. Okay. Whoops. As you can see, we have some thermal paste pasting this box with screws, so we have apparently very nice setup here, but first I need to clean this mess. I hope we do not have too much beryllium oxide in this, because you can see it is quite something, so let me deal with it and we'll be right back. Okay, much better. So where this box? Apparently, it is possible to open it, but the label here on this side. So I hope it is socketed here. It looks like yes. So your guess is as good as mine. Maybe it is a DC to DC power converter. Maybe something else we will find out, hopefully. First, I will undo this layer here of stuff. A lot of screws in this thing. So again, flex rigid assembly. Some screws provided with washers, some other not. Did they forget one in the factory? Okay. So, wow. So, again, already here we have a nice relay. But this, two more relays here from Teledyne, some filtering assemblies here. But here, so a few auxiliary ICs, but this, apparently space grade part. I will research them and will find out, try to find out what it is and how much money it costs if it is still available. Really, really nice. Some bulge resistors here, you can see, for adjustment or something. More of those fancy test points. So it is called the filter PCB. So yes, we can expect to find some kind of voltage converter inside here, I believe. So I will try to undo all this with no damage. But for this purpose, I guess the best thing will be to use sockets. So what, like your guess, metric or imperial? It is not 6. 7 is a lot too big. Okay. So I get out the imperial set. And surely enough, 1/4 inch. So let's undo those things here first. All the screws are rusty in this thing, well, oxidized for some, and other rusty, quite weird. Not sure what happened here because it was never used or never installed. Okay. So it is ready to have a complete look at the thing, make a way. No. So on this one we will have the infamous 3/16 inch. Really annoying little hardware. Okay. So if everything goes according to plan, I should be able to lift. Or not. I am not sure. Ah. This might be in the way. could be better without it. I hope. What? Really? No, because this one is actually mounted on a, not on the other side. So it looks like, after all, it is soldered in place and it will not collaborate with me. And now this is loose, very nice. Not a big deal actually. So what I will do instead, I will just undo the back cover. And let's hope we will be able to figure out what we have in here. So at least the cover is coming off. Probably just a DC to DC power converter, I guess. But we never know, so. Hope it is not anymore. Okay, so you can see. I am not sure if it will be possible to take it apart any further. But we have a very power supply-ish thing with thermal pads. With transistors apparently. Or regulators here soldered on the sides. Not possible to see if they are again space grade or not, but you can see at least those diodes. Wow. I believe it is first time ever I see such a package. Look at this. Interesting, regular tantalum caps at least. So I will not be able to undo it any further because I guess we have nuts behind these screws. You need to reach from the other side. But it looks like from the feeling, general, if I compare in fact. This part here, you can see this one. And what I can see from these ones, it looks like we might have more space grade transistors in here. Yes, 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 yes. Look at this. This one also. I can see it is a metal body completely. And we have four of them. Okay, those are more usual MOSFETs, apparently. Regular tantalum caps, regular MLCCs. Big one here. Okay. So, interesting. So, there is a thermal pad for the diodes here, obviously. So, it is a DC to DC, or power supply box of some description. It is actually written on a label here. I can see there is a label here, but it is impossible to reach it, and I do not want to try to unsolder everything here because it will be a pain, obviously. I do not have a powerful solder sucker thing, so maybe with the soldering needles it could be possible, but the box will probably be branded Vinten and will be a power supply something. Okay. So I will try to clean a little bit more that mess of thermal goop. And then I will put this back together. So really, really interesting device. Beautiful electronics. As always with Vinten, check my Tornado Flare Dispenser video. With more Vinten electronics. Really, really beautiful things. Complicated flat flex. Space grade parts sometimes. lot of goals in the connectors and the test points and everything for a JVC tape drive. Okay, so thanks for watching. Bye bye.